In this episode, we're gonna talk about default developed settings in Lightroom. It's gonna really help you go from really blah raw images to awesome raw images.
Adorama TV presents Exploring Photography with Mark Wallace.
Hi everybody, welcome to another episode of Exploring Photography right here on Adorama TV, brought to you as always by Adorama, the best camera store in the entire world. If you need something for photography, well, Adorama's got it. Check them out at Adorama.com. Well, I'm Mark Wallace and I'm hanging out here in Cartagena, Colombia. And earlier I was walking around through the walled city, the old part of town, and I was talking to some tourists like me, and they were telling me that they recently upgraded their cameras because they were going on this really cool trip, and they decided to start shooting in RAW format. So they went from JPEG to RAW, and what they found was, what they said was, when they started looking at their images in Lightroom, well, the RAW images don't look as good as the JPEG images. In fact, I hear this all the time from people that switch from JPEG to RAW. They said, what's going on here? I thought this was supposed to be awesome and my RAW images were going to be spectacular, but they don't look as good as my old JPEG images, so what's going on? Well, by default, when you set your camera to shoot in JPEG mode, the camera's doing a bunch of stuff for you. It's looking at the image and it's setting the sharpness of that image. It's changing the color saturation. It's setting contrast. It's doing all those kinds of things to really make it so when you take the image right out of the camera, you can print it or share it with friends or do whatever. And that's awesome. It's really fast. But the downside is that you don't have as much leeway, much flexibility in post-production as you do if you shot in RAW. It also means that you have to do some things to your RAW images to make them look like your JPEG images right out of the camera. Now, the nice thing is, if you're using Lightroom, this is really, really simple. All you need to do is set up your default develop settings one time, and then you're good to go. Your RAW images are going to pop into Lightroom, and they're going to look just as good as your JPEG images. And it's really super easy to do this. So let's take a look at how to do that right now. I'm in Lightroom 5, and I'd like to begin by telling you what a default develop setting is. Now, when you import files into Lightroom, by default, some things happen in the Develop module. So let's go over to the Develop module and look and see some of the important things. One of the most important is the sharpening that we get. So if I zip up here to sharpening, you'll see that it's sharpened by about 25 with a radius of 1, etc. So not a lot of sharpening is happening, and so if you have a really high resolution camera, you're missing out on a lot of the clarity. RAW files need sharpening. And then the other thing that is not or really not happening is the presence. In other words, the vibrance and the saturation, they're right at zero, so the colors may be suffering here. And then also the contrast really isn't changed at all. It's just all zeroed out, a very, very neutral developed setting. And so what's going to be better is for you to change these, and so the images come in with some sweetening done to them. They'll be sharpened, they'll be a little bit more vibrant, maybe a little bit more contrasty. And so that way they'll look much more like the JPEG images, which have all of that happening in the camera. And so we have to do some work to make sure that all happens. All right, so the very first thing to understand is these settings need to be specific to your camera. Why? Well, I'm gonna go up here to just my quick collection here. I wanna show you something. So here's a little selfie that Lex and I did in Rio de Janeiro here. Now this was done with my iPhone. If I go over to the develop setting, I'll go down to my sharpening. I'm going to sharpen this to about 100. And you can see that looks horrible. So we look like we have skin that's been out in the sun way too long. And so sharpening a JPEG image to 100 is just no good because, you know, it's already been sharpened in the camera. So I don't want to do that. But if I go back here, here is a little shot of a little dog that I met in Patagonia. This little guy followed me around everywhere. If I go to the develop module and I take this sharpening and I'm going to take that all the way up to about 100, notice that looks really good. In fact, that's probably about the right amount of sharpening. So sharpening for an image shot with a Leica M Type 240 is absolutely not the same kind of sharpening that you would want to use for an iPhone photo. And the same is true with all the other settings. The saturation settings, the vibrant settings, etc. So we really want to make sure that when we bring in a photo from our iPhone or from a different type of camera, it doesn't have the same develop settings that are set up for something like a 5D Mark III or a Leica, etc. So we want to make our settings specific to our camera, or we're going to get a lot of images that look really, really nasty. How do we do that? Well, what we want to do is go up to our Lightroom, and preferences, or if you're on a PC, it'd be file preferences. Notice this: these are not catalog settings, these are preferences, and that means that these changes are going to affect every single Lightroom catalog that you have. It's really important. If you want something that's really specific just to your catalog, what you want to do is set up some develop presets and apply those on import. These are default develop settings that apply to everything that you bring in across all catalogs. All right, we need to make sure though that they are specific to your camera. And so on the presets tab, there is a little tick right here, a little checkbox that says make the defaults specific to your camera's serial number. And you want to make sure that's checked. It's going to be specific to your serial number. That means if you have two or three different 5D Mark IIIs, maybe you're shooting weddings or sports, you can make these specific to each camera because sometimes cameras behave slightly different. So make sure that's checked. The other thing that you can check if you want is to make these defaults specific to your camera ISO settings. Why would you do that? Well, doing noise reduction for an ISO of 100 is not the same as doing noise reduction for an ISO of 3200 or 6400. And so if you're shooting in a lot of different environments, like a wedding photographer or an event photographer or a sports photographer, you might want to set these up not only specific to your camera, but to your camera's specific ISO settings. And so you can really tune in the noise reduction and get that right. It'll save you a ton of time. We're just gonna do this specific to our camera's serial number. So once that's checked, you can close that box. Hey, before we continue, I wanna remind you that Adorama has some awesome photography contests. It's absolutely free to participate and you can win some great prizes. So click the link and enter today. All right, so I'm gonna go back to all of my photographs here. And what I want to do is I need to get a representative group of photos that I can use to make some changes and figure out what setting works best for most photos. Because sharpening for scenic photography is a little bit different than sharpening for portrait photography, etc. So I want to find a middle ground. The best way to do that is go up here to your metadata and then look at all the different cameras that you use. And I'm going to choose my Leica. And I want to make this specific to my Leica. And then the next thing I want to do is I'm going to go to my attributes here and get my images that I flagged as winners. And then I'll just choose some different samples. So I want to choose perhaps some scenic photos. So I'll get this Mount Fitzroy photo here. I'll get a picture of a person here. This is an awesome guy I met here. It's, anyway, really cool at a meetup here. And that was in Santiago. Maybe some people on the street, some scenic photos, street photos. You get the idea. You just want to get a bunch of different photos that you can use to do some sharpening and some adjustments and then see what works best for most photos and then go from there. So I'm just going to really quickly get a bunch of these. Then I'm going to go up to the top here and go to my library. And then I will say, I want a new collection. And then I'll call this default testing. Create that. All right, now I can close this. I can just go through here and I can bring this into my develop module. So this is a man I met on the street and I can start sharpening this. So sharpen this up to around, I think we found about 100 looked pretty good. I'm looking at the skin. Does that look good? I think it does. I'll go to the next shot here. Here's this little puppy that I met. How's the sharpening work for that? So the very first thing I'm going to do is play with the sharpening. I already know by trial and error and spending a lot of time that for my Leica, about 100, radius 1 and all these other settings, that works about right for my Leica. So I've got my sharpening locked down. The next thing I want to do is look and see what about color saturation. So I'm going to go here and grab something with some color. This is a guy that was dancing a jig in front of his fruits, which is really cool. Then I'm going to go in here and I'm going to play with the vibrance. Now, the difference between vibrance and saturation takes all the colors and makes them more saturated. Vibrance takes the colors that are least saturated and brings them up. So I prefer to increase my vibrance just a little bit, not my saturation, but it's up to you. You can do whatever you want. You might want to increase the clarity. Maybe your camera doesn't have a lot of contrast, so you might want to increase that. But you want to do whatever it is that works best for you and do this across a bunch of photos. And so spend some time going in, changing the sharpening, the clarity, the vibrance, and see what works best. And then once you have it all dialed in, and by the way, take a good amount of time. I spent a couple hours doing this across a bunch of photos and found that sort of that sweet spot that worked for most photos. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to grab this, and this is the setting that I found for me that works. I found that having my vibrance up just a little bit, sharpening my image quite a bit, that was a good baseline for me. I didn't really have to do much to my exposure or contrast with this camera. Well, once you have that all set, again, remember, take a lot of time, do a lot of photos, make some notes, figure out what settings work best for most images. Once you have that done, you're going to go up to develop and then set default settings. So once you have that, click on that, and you're going to get this very scary dialog box that says, hey, do you want to change this for all of your camera raw images with the following properties, serial number and the model of your camera, etc. And then it says these changes cannot be undone. These are not undoable. So just be aware that once you update your current settings, you're not really going to be able to go back, which isn't really true. You can just go back to one that wasn't changed and didn't have the saturation and update that with those current settings. So this update current settings takes the settings from the whatever photo that you currently have loaded in the develop module, and it's going to update. So now whenever you bring in any image, the settings that you have set, the sharpening, whatever it is, those will automatically be applied. You don't have to set a preset. You don't have to do anything to bring those in. So now when your photos come in, they're really gonna look great. Now one quick thing that you might want to do when you're making all your changes, there's a shortcut key in the develop module. It's the Y key. And so if you click that, if you click when you're in the develop module, click Y, you're gonna get a before and after image. And then you can zoom in to a specific point. And so I will do that. I'm gonna kick out the panels by hitting tab. And what you can do is you can look and say, hey, did the image on the after, on the right-hand side, does that look better than the image that I started with? And you can compare and see if the sharpening looks good or not and do different variations of that. And you can start seeing what images look good. And remember to do this at 100% zoom. Don't do this when it's all zoomed out. Make sure you zoom in on your image, make the changes to make sure they really, really look good. Once that's done, update your default develop settings and you're off to the races.
Well, it's super easy to set up your default develop settings in Lightroom, and it's gonna make a huge difference for those of you who have switched from JPEG to RAW, or maybe you haven't known about this. So do it today, super fast, super easy, and it's gonna really take your post-processing time down considerably. Well, thank you so much for joining me with this episode of Exploring Photography. Don't forget, you can subscribe to Adorama TV. It's absolutely free. So click on the button and do that today. And don't forget to check out the Adorama Learning Center. There are hundreds of articles on every conceivable topic. And of course, it's free. So do that today. Thanks again for joining me, and I will see you again next time.
Do you want great-looking prints at low cost? Be sure to visit our easy-to-use online printing service. Adorama Pix has professionals who treat your images with the utmost care that you can count on. For a quick turnaround on photos, cards, or albums, use adoramapix.com.